So anyway, so we have that same miracle-working power that God has placed within us that Elisha had. No different. And are we ready to pick up that mantle? You might say, well, aren't I doing that already? Well, I don't know. Have you raised the dead? Are you laying hands on the sick? Are they recovering? I mean, we get prayer. We have people getting healed here. But I want to see it all the time. We prayed over someone who died and came back to life, but I want to see it all the time. We're praying for people that we are contending for. I want to see. I said, Lord, again this morning, I was praying in the spirit. I said, Lord, I said, your delays are not your denials. We're not giving up. We want to see this manifestation of divine healing. Amen. It's like Elijah in that prayer posture. And he's saying, I see the cloud the size of a man's hand. That's what we're saying. Lord, I see that cancer the size of a man's hand being destroyed and eaten up. Lord, I see that heart issue. I see that prodigal. Look, see, we're not giving up. And that's what the tenacity that the Lord wants from all of us, that we're standing in the gap. And we're like, no, we know who we are in Christ, and we're not backing down. The enemy wants to wear the saints out, but he says, those who know their God, what shall do great exploits for him. Amen? Are you one of those saints? I am. We're going to do great exploits. That's for every one of us. That's the privilege we all have, okay? So we want that double portion anointing. In Luke 1:17. It says, you're talking about John here. It says, and he himself will go before him in the spirit and power of Elisha to turn back the hearts of the fathers to the children and the disobedient and incredulous and unpersuadable to the wisdom of the upright, which is the knowledge and holy love of the will of God, in order to make ready for the Lord a people perfectly prepared in spirit. Hear me. Adjusted, disposed, and placed in the right moral state. Amen? That's us. He's saying, listen, get the how out of here. We heard, what's that guy's name? Bishop Garlington say that. Get the how out of here. I'm not cussing. How do we do this, God? How do we do this, God? But God is saying, get the how out and trust me. Amen. And trust me, he knows, you know, his ways. In Isaiah 55, it says his ways are above our ways. His thoughts are above our thoughts. We can't figure them out. If we can figure them out, why do we need to pray to God? Right. So we need to know that he's there's a pattern that you see here, making ready a people, a living sacrifice before our God. In 1 Kings 17:1, in the Amplified, it says, Elijah the Tishbite of the temporary residence of Gilead said to Ahab, as the Lord, the God of Israel, lives before whom I stand, there shall not be dew or rain these years, but according to my word. That's the authority we have. That's the power we have. That's what I'm going for. Amen. So if you want to operate in this, then it's like, you know, we have to be convinced that God has called us more than a conqueror. He says that we are courageous. He says that we are powerful. We have the El Gibor, the spirit of a champion within us. That's one of the characters. That's one of the names of God. That's who we are. And so to stand in the gap means we intercede, but we also pray for ourselves. You say, yeah, but you don't understand my family. I don't, you know, listen, I'm not minimizing that. We all have had family issues. We've all had problems. But God has broken through, right? We can all have people come up here and give testimony of the miracle-working power of how God broke through in all of our lives. And so we're not going to leave it there. We're not going to live on yesterday's testimonies. Come on, it's God's word is alive. It's supernatural. It's living. We have Zoe life within us. So God is calling for to break out of the secret service Christian. God is saying, no, I don't want you to be in a secret service community. I want you to be alive and ministering to the body and to the people out there that they see the glow in the dark. Like Peter would always quote that scripture in the message where it says that he wants us to be glow in the dark Christians. In that darkness, they see the light of Christ Jesus within us. We have the answer. We have the answer, right? So anyway, so he's calling us to be those powerful representatives. Powerful. That's not afraid to take a stand for God. That's not afraid to stand against the woke mentality, cancer culture. The LGBT community needs us. They're just lost. They need breakthrough. They need that healing. They need the restoration. They need the love of Jesus Christ, right? And so not just them, any addiction, anything, any kind of struggles, but how much of the church is still living this life? The church is living this life because it's been complacent, the church at large. And so it's like we can't, it's more, it, you know, God, I remember in the 90s, it was all about whether you got a goosebump or you're experiencing something. Listen, there are times you're standing in faith. Most of the time, you're not feeling anything. It's by faith, period, right? So in 1 Kings 18, it says here, Elijah came near to all the people and said, how long will you halt and limp between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if it's Baal, follow him. And the people didn't answer him a word. That's right. They couldn't. Idolatry, all the things that the world has to offer us can't answer you. It doesn't have the answer. It might be fun for a season, but it cannot answer you. How long will you limp between two opinions? And I'm asking the church that. How long will we limp between two opinions? Either we're all in. God, you're going for it. I don't care. I'm standing on the word. I'm trusting you, Jesus. Or we're straddling the fence. Where are you? I mean, we all have to look introspectively here. In the just the Amplified, it says, how long will you hesitate between two opinions? And hesitation there means double-mindedness. Unsteady, it refers to unsteadiness in a person's decision. And see, God meets us where we're at. He's not, listen, if we're having a problem with doubt, he works with us. But we don't want to give it up.